75% of the corals are dying as a result of a bleaching event. That's what you would hear reported in the literature. What the literature doesn't say is that 25% survive. And they are our super corals. They are the ones that are thriving in conditions that are making others very ill. And what we see is that some corals that have experienced stressful conditions on the reef and survived are somehow better able to withstand that same stress the next time. So if you will, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. And so what we are trying to do in the laboratory is give them something that challenges their biology and will translate to them performing better on the reef.
In this system, we're controlling temperature so we can expose a single coral colony to a variety of different conditions.
This apparatus allows us to measure the amount of energy going into and out of this coral fragment here.
I'm actually blasting the tissue off of the coral skeleton so that we can look at more genetics.
We stress the coral with higher temperature, and we identify corals that are resistant to that stress.
We perform these measurements at higher temperatures because for some of these corals, it takes less energy to survive in harsher conditions.
We extract the DNA to see what genes are active and if this might help them become more resistant to these future climate change conditions.
So we are essentially developing corals that we can now use to restore or to build resilience on damaged reefs. That is, we can outplant them. What we are attempting to do is create capacity to stabilize the reefs. Our project is harnessing the complexity and the diversity of biology that exists on the coral reef. And it's that very variation that I think is gonna help save our reefs.